At 11 a.m., the body of the late Henry Chemba arrived at Parliament, where it was received by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, before it was laid in state at the foyer where MPs and other mourners got a chance to have a view. At 2 p.m., the casket was moved to Chambers of Parliament for legislators to pay tribute to the gallant son of the soil in a special Parliament sitting, which started with laying wreaths on the casket in honor. Rebecca Kadaga, the first Deputy Prime Minister, who doubles as the Minister for East African Affairs, moved a motion for the resolution of Parliament to pay tribute to the late former minister and distinguished civil servant. Kadaga described Chemba as a strong advocate and promoter of democracy, good governance, and champion of strengthening public administration.
When Chemba was a distinguished statesman, one of the great senior leaders in this country, whom we should emulate for his patriotism. Onachemba is famously known for the book he authored, entitled State of Blood, the inside story of Idi Amin, which provides a first-hand account of his experience as a Minister of Health in Uganda.
The Leader of Opposition, Mathias Mpoga, seconded the motion and hailed the late for taking off time to put down the history of Uganda in his book, State of the Blood.
As I stand to second the motion raised by the Right Honourable Rebecca Kadaga to pay tribute to the late Henry Chemba, he spoke ably on quite a number of subjects that one of only had to sustain debate with if they were not well grounded. He generously offered time and space to whoever came to him with a thirst to sit down at the feet of a guru to learn.
Mpoga defended the decision by the opposition to call off their protest and return to Parliament following events of the past week, saying there was need to celebrate the legacy of a distinguished statesman.
Right Honourable Speaker, just to assure the House that we came for this sitting and retreat back in our bunker until Normalisa returns home.
The Vice President of Uganda, retired Major Jessica Alupo, eulogized Chemba as a dignified statesman and applauded President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni for giving Chemba an official burial.
The Honorable Chemba was a distinguished statesman, as already described by the Right Honorable Prime Minister in the motion. Therefore, I stand here to support the motion. May the soul of the Right Honorable Henry Chemba rest in eternal peace, and may the Lord sustain the bereaved.
Legislators have generally recognized Chemba as a man of impeccable integrity who contributed much to grooming of young politicians, not only in Busoga sub-region where he hails from.
And that the rate was one person who could reconcile them whenever they had misunderstandings.
The late Honorable Chemba has been a man of wisdom, and we've been consulting, we've been going to his place and make consultations about many matters concerning Jinja City, the country at large, and he has been ready and available to offer free information.
Born on 8 December 1939 in Mayuge District, Chemba succumbed to diabetes-related complications. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.